worship. Thank you for the spirit you have given us to open our lips and to worship you and to declare your glory among all nations. We pray, O Lord, as we come and dig into your word will make a meaning and will make a sense in our lives. May this word come with inspiration and power to change us and make us a better people. Thank you, Father, for hearing us. In Jesus' name we pray. In Hebrews chapter 2, Hebrews chapter 2 from verse 1. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. That scripture introduces us to what I call diligence. This scripture introduces us to living a life of diligence as a Christian, as a pilgrim, as one who has not been to heaven before, as one coming to eternal kingdom of God, one who you know in your mind, you know in your spirit, that if you don't give earnest heed to Christian life you are living today, to the Christian life you are living in the world, you face temptations every day, you face trials every day, afflictions in the world every day, persecution every day, as one if you are not very careful, even though you have worshipped God, even though you profess the name of the Lord, even though you have been singing praises to God, if you are not very, very careful with your life, if you don't give the more energy to the things you have heard, to the things you've been hearing, to the things you have heard this morning, to the one you are even hearing now, and to the one you will yet hear all through your Christian life and journey, believe you me, you will get to the gates of heaven and you'll be told, sorry, we never knew you. Therefore, we ought to give the most earnest heed to the things which we have had, lest at any time we should let them slip. Therefore, we ought to give. You and I ought to give. We are supposed to give the more earnest heed. Now, the word therefore introduces us to the things that have been said before. A lot has been said. You have known a lot. You have heard a lot. You yourself have been privileged to preach to people. You have had a lot through counseling, one-on-one counseling to your pastor, to any minister, to any man of God. You have had a lot about eternity. You have had a lot about heaven. You have had a lot about hell. You have had a lot about salvation. You have had a lot about restitution. You have had a lot about living the life of holiness, living the life of victory over sin, living the life of victory over temptation. You have had a lot. Therefore, you ought, having heard the things you heard, having listened diligently to the things that have been preached to you, having attended programs, having heard of our personal love for God, personal love for your soul, personal love for you to have eternity in heaven. That's why we came here. But as cheap as it is, finding eternal life, possessing eternal life that opens the pearly gates of heaven for you, brother, sister, it's not cheap. I don't know that you understand. Having eternal life that takes you to heaven and live with God forever and ever is not true. Therefore, I implore you, you need to give the more earnest way. Moses, you were not too diligent. Moses, you did not give the more earnest heed. When God was instructing you, speak to the rock. You didn't give the most earnest heed. And as he came before the people, he looked at them, ye rebels, and spoke in anger. And instead of speaking to the rock, he lifted up his staff and smote the rock. Remember, Moses, you have smitten the rock before. And the Bible said the rock you smote before was Christ. And Christ must be smitten only once because he's only going to die once. Moses, you are changing divine order and pattern. Give the more NSE. Nobody changes divine order and pattern and God's free under God's grace. Moses came. God took him to Mount Pisgah. And they went to the top of Mount Pisgah. God told Moses, you did not give the more NSE to the instructions I gave you. Look at the promised land. You will see it with your eyes, but you will never go in there. What am I saying? Eternal life is not cheap. Eternal life, going to heaven, the heavenly gate opening up to you, and you stepping into heaven, you know now, the type of life you live, you will say, wonder, if this type of life will take me to heaven, and then God is no more God. Then God is no more holy and righteous as he is. Then God is no more just. Therefore, give the more earnest heed to the things you have heard and the things you have learned. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of the word. What is God saying here? Give the more earnest heed. Sodom and Gomorrah. God came to the people at that time and said, tomorrow by this time, this city shall be no more. Sodom and Gomorrah have been programmed in heaven to be burned down with fire. Lord, do you have any person in this city that you can go and do your final evangelism? You have been set up as a strategic person to reach out to the people in this city. Lord, I am giving you last chance. Go in, do your evangelism. Work hard. If there is anybody related to you that you want to be saved, go and convince them. And Lord went round the entire city. They laughed him to scorn. Hey, what are you talking about? Maybe Maria will speak to Chukuma. Did you see Papa in your house yesterday evening? He said, ah, Papa came here last night, bro. Papa came here and was talking and said, if you don't leave Sodom and Gomorrah, this place will be destroyed with fire. Is something wrong with Papa? Let's gather money tomorrow and take him to psychiatric hospital. You need to see how Papa is looking. So haggard. Papa did not wear shoe. Papa came here with boxer. Papa was running up and down, asking us to leave. How can this city like this? How can a city like Abuja, Abuja, where Asoro is, Abuja, all these houses, Abuja, all the companies, Abuja, all the rich people, Abuja, all the mansions, Abuja, all the roads, all the streets, all the fine houses. How can? Can you see what happened, Papa? Tomorrow, let's meet a meeting, family meeting. Papa must go to hospital. We don't want to leave Papa. Papa was going from place to place. They laugh and laugh. They broke. The angel told Papa, get ready. We are on divine timing. We have known divine timing and program. In few minutes from now, this city shall be destroyed. They will enter here and come out. Climb upstairs. If there was also that, there was also at that time. Climb up and come down. Enter the balcony. Come out from the balcony. Enter the bedroom. Enter Madame's room. Enter Papa's room. Enter this parlor. Sit down in this parlor. Come out here. What do we do? Go up. And the angel came and said, the time is up. Can we move? And the Bible said, while they linger. Why they do what? Why they do what? What's lingering? Delay. In their mind, is this really so? We have never seen fire destroy a whole city. Can it happen? Is God that wicked? These things, can it be so? I don't really think so. I don't think so. The Bible says one angel held the hand of the wife and held the hand of the husband. The other angel held the hand of the first daughter and held the hand of the other and did what? And pulled them out. As he released their hands, I am sounding a warning to you. Husband and wife, pastor and wife, I'm sending a warning to you, daughters, pastor's children. You know, pastor and children are very familiar with the word of God. Pastors and children and the family are very familiar with God. God may not really think so. God may not really say so. He said, escape for your life and run to the mountain Hida. Don't look back. He did not say, don't turn. Hello? If you don't say what? Don't turn. Did he say what? You can look back without turning. Am I right?
You can look back.
Have I turned? Am I looking back? Have I turned? He said, don't look back. And release them. Not why he said no. It's not so. Giving the more earnest heed. For if every word and transgression was judged by angels, and that woman was running, at the time, she decided to do what? To look back. Before the statue of Lot's wife was destroyed in Israel, when you go to Israel, you will see that woman like this, as she attempted to turn like this to look back. God's judgment fell. Yeah! If Lot had attempted to look, what would have happened to him? Yeah! He learned a lesson. he looked by the side, he didn't see the wife again. So he knew she had looked back. And he knew that the judgment of God had fallen on her. She looked back. I don't think Lot's wife turned up completely. As she was running to the mountain where the angel said, run to, and she looked like this, the judgment fell. How is it that you have heard, you have not heard this today, you've heard it separately, that every woman that palms are here, and Jericho's are here, and put on earrings, will never see heaven, however she tries. And you relax. You're still singing in the choir. You're still an usher. Nothing is moving you. It has not touched you. You feel you are missing the truth. You are saying in your mind, I will do what I want to do. Nobody can drive me away from this church. That's true. Nobody will drive you away. But we will see whether you will enter heaven. I'm talking weeping. How is it that you heard that if a woman wears trousers, she will never go to heaven? And the woman shall not wear that way pertaining unto a man. And a man shall not put on a man's garment, a woman's garment. For all that do so. Come, why is it that the women argue about men's dress? And when we men, as I come now, I put on blouse, I put on scarf, I put on skirt, I put on woman's shoe, and I walk in here. Women, are you going to remain here? Is it that you heard that if any man gives bribe, he's a sinner? And you say give bribe. How is it that you heard that fornicators will not have any place in the kingdom of God? He that destroyed God's temple, him shall God destroy. You hear this strong language of the scriptures, and you know that every transgression and disobedience, as we have read, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation? How are you going to escape? For the great day of the wrath of God is come, and who shall be able to stand? You hear all those words, and you remain the same. You harden your heart. You cross your heart. You cross up your heart. You say, I will keep coming to church. Nobody can do me anything. This is my church. I will keep coming. Yes, you can keep coming. Nobody indeed will talk to you. Nobody indeed will drive you away. But I ask you today again, how shall you escape? If every transgression was judged, if every disobedience was judged, if every instruction given by the angels of God was thoroughly judged, was diligently judged, when those angels spoke those words, although they were on earth and God is in heaven, the words that came out from their mouth were not their own words, were the words of God telling them to tell them. God was standing by, watching to see who will transgress that word. And as Lot's wife attempted to transgress, God judged. Are you brazen up to face God's judgment? Are you getting ready? Or you want us to smile with you, looking for your friendship? Your friendship, more than the word of God, is there true fellowship without truth? Can there be true fellowship between you and I without truth? Can there be true righteous, true relationship between you and I without the truth of God's word? Then if truth is removed from our relationship, if truth is removed from fellowship, there is a social garden. I'm not part of it. So I value relationship with God than friendship with you. So I tell you the truth. For it is the truth that sets free. You hear words like this, and your heart does not shake. Your heart does not fear. Your heart does not quake. Nothing moves your mind. I'm sorry. Yesterday I had to shift these choir members from the front seat to the back. Why? The stairs are here. As the seat opposite us, how many of you are here yesterday? You cannot freely look to the other side conveniently. I have to say, don't sit in the front, go to the back. You mean you don't know that mini skirt is bad? Your parents do not teach you that mini skirt is bad? The pastor in this church has not told you science, reasoning, has not told you. You've not heard revelations. You've not seen a man that died and come back to life and say, God say, God say, God say. And you remain the same. Nothing moves you. Nothing touch your heart. You don't fear God. The thief on the cross about dying, ask the other thief, dost thou not fear God? You prove to us that our labor is in vain. You are proving to the pastor that all the time spent, all the energy spent, all the effort spent, all the things he has laid down his life to be doing in this life is a waste. Is the worst? Emmanuel knows. In the last 4 or 5 months, how many days have I sat down in my home with my wife? How many days? Sometimes in a week I connect 2 states by flights. Running here, wake up, come in the night, wake up early in the morning, my children don't see me, they wake up, they don't see me. I go again, come back in the night, wake up in the morning, go out, my children don't see me. And we are laboring like this among you. We are doing everything. We are sacrificing our life. We are depriving ourselves of the pleasures of the world, of any other enjoyment, even physical food. Sometimes we don't eat. Days. Trying to bring this word of life, the word of eternal life, the word of God, the word of grace that builds you up and bring eternal life to you. You want to tell us it's a waste? You want to let us know and discourage us that it's a waste? Bow your head, let's pray. Give them more in a seed. If you value your soul, if you value your life, let me announce to you, one day you will leave this world, whether you like it or not. For many have left in your very eyes. What makes you think you will live longer than them? What makes you think you will live forever in this world? Where is Abacha? Where is Yaradua? Where is Gaddafi? Where is Mandela? Where are they? Where is Reagan? U.S. President? Where are they? Come, where is Paul the Apostle? Where is Moses? Are they still alive? They have gone to the great beyond. As much as God used them, God took their ways away because they must obey the law of nature. You want to make us feel that our sacrifice, our labor is in vain? Give them more in a seed. Give them more in a seed. Give them more in a seed. Give diligence. Give diligence to your life. Give attention to your life. If you like praying, if you like don't pray, you're not praying to me. You are not praying for me, you are praying for yourself. So if you like, pray. If you like, keep quiet. It is for yourself. Everything you do for yourself, not for anybody. Everything you are doing is for yourself. Everything. Some people think they do things to hit the pastor, but never. Don't think so. Everything you do it for yourself and not for anybody. If you like, play. If you like, keep quiet. If you like, be laughing. It is for yourself. I've spoken to you the word of God.